Welcome everyone to the placement series. With us we have Sophie Matthew from ENTC department. She is placed in Cognizant. So hello Sophie, welcome to the placement series. So can you give us an overlook about the job title that you are having or about the company?
Okay, hi. So I'm placed in Cognizant Technology Solutions. So Cognizant was one of the mass recruiters that had come to MIT for placements. It took around 200, 230 students on an average. The package that they offered was 4 lakhs per annum. And the job description that has been given in the offer letter is programmer analyst trainee. Yeah.
Okay. So what were the different patterns of selection or the criteria? First, mainly we have to go through the criteria. What was the criteria?
Okay. So I don't think Cognizant had a lot of criteria. Their basic criteria was 6.25. They did not have any objection to backlogs. They did not have any objection. They did not have any objection to any percentage marks in your 10th and 12th. That was not a criteria for them. They did not have any objection about backlogs also. So I think the criteria was comparatively low, and all departments could apply. So even though it was a core IT job, I'm from ENTC and I could apply for the job.
Okay, so what were the different stages of selection?
All right. So basically Cognizant had three stages of selection. First was their aptitude test, second was their technical round. And so, unlike usually, most companies at the time were having the aptitude round where you had to go to the college and give the aptitude test. So unlike that, this was not like that. Cognizant, you could give the test remotely. So you could sit at your house and there was remote monitoring. So one thing that was very strict about Cognizant, which was not there in other companies, was that the Cognizant, the camera and the video recording was very strict. So once we were selected for the HR, technical round, they had actually taken a printout of our face while giving the aptitude test. So they were actually checking that. So if they actually saw someone else peeking into the camera screen or anyone in the background, you were immediately disqualified from their further rounds. So that was one thing which was there specifically in Cognizant, which no other company had done.
Okay, so what about the aptitude and technical test?
See, the aptitude test was honestly very easy. If you search online for Cognizant aptitude tests, you will find a lot of questions which are exactly those questions had come in the aptitude test. There was not even a numerical value ka change. Everything was the same for the aptitude round. Now, the technical and HR, it depends very greatly on who your interviewer is. Okay, so for me, I had a pretty laid-back interviewer. And I was very upfront about the fact that I do not know very good coding and that I am learning coding. So that was one of the things that he appreciated, that I was honest about this. Another friend of mine, I'm just giving you out of experience, that other people who behaved who showed a slight amount of disrespect or attitude of some kind, they were immediately given a very tough time by the interviewer. So you have to behave like yourself, honest. You have to be very honest. If your interviewer asks you as to do you know coding, don't say that I know 3 languages. Just tell them how much you know and what you know. So for my technical round, I was asked that, do you know coding? And I said, no, I don't know coding. I'm learning and I know the basics. So the questions asked to me were also very basic questions of computer. Like I was asked a flowchart. I was asked an algorithm. I was asked a pseudocode. I was never asked to do any hard coding. I was asked basic syntax. Then I was asked about ENTC, which is my department. They asked me my favorite subject. They asked me random questions about my favorite subject. Nothing in particular or nothing in specific. Because the interviewer also did not have that much knowledge about the subject which I was talking about. Another thing that they focused on was internships. I had done one internship in Cummins before I went for the interview. So they focused a lot on that. And the third thing I was focused on my technical interview was my ethical skills. Now, this may depend from interviewer to interviewer, but I asked around 4 to 5 questions on my ethics, my company ethics or my work ethics.
So this it was included in HR or only in technical?
In technical. This was in technical. In my technical, my interviewer asked me all these questions.
Okay. So what about the HR then?
Yeah. So HR was actually, since we were a lot of people and it was almost by the end of the day, my interview. So HR round was comparatively shorter. So they just asked me as to why you want to switch from ENTC to the IT sector. One very basic question they asked. And the other second question they asked was, why Cognizant? Now, another thing I feel that everyone should do in the HR round is that when they ask, do you have any questions? Please keep a question in mind ready. So, since I had in my CV about Jigyasa, which is an NGO, and I have worked in other NGOs, I asked them about their CSR or the corporate social responsibility. So that they answered. So it's just a suggestion that I feel that everyone should have one question which you want to ask the interviewer, which makes them looked up on their company or you have researched on their company.
Okay. So what about the GD? Was there any group discussion or any other kind?
No, there was no GD. There was no group discussion for Cognizant.
Okay. So like you have mentioned already a lot of mistakes that other students should have done, shouldn't have done. So any anything else mistake you have to add in this or any misconceptions?
Okay. So there are a lot of people who feel that appearance does not matter, but honestly, it does. Like if they have mentioned whatever the dress code is, thankfully we had a dress code. Like we had a uniform when we had to go for placements. Please stick to that dress code. Please don't wear, you know, like if you're a girl, don't wear, you know, flashy shoes and flashy nail polish and dress yourself up because it's an interview. Please behave like you're going for an interview. And you may think that all these small, small things don't matter, but honestly, they do. This is the first thing that they check when you walk in. Second thing is have your certificates, have your all of that organized so that when they ask, you know, you should know your folder and what they're looking for. So if they ask for something, you should be able to open it and give it to you. He is not going to go through your file. And the third thing is that please be confident. If you don't know something, say you don't know it. If you know something, say you know it. But don't lie to them and walk in confidently. Don't walk in like you're scared of the interviewer because then he'll take full advantage of that fact.
So anything from the college activities or extracurriculum that helped you through the course?
Yeah, so I have participated in a lot of extracurricular activities, you know, like I was part of the magazine and then anchoring and, you know, I've participated in different things. So my resume had quite a lot of things in that. So I think that is very important that if you don't have a special skill, at least you participate in activities which shows that you are willing to try or you're willing to experiment or explore. So I think honestly, it doesn't matter which college activity it is in, but you should try and you should participate in as many activities as possible. Go for hackathons, go for challenges. If you're not interested in the technical sector, go for maybe, you know, non-technical things, but participate. Participate in something or the other so that when your interview comes up, you have something to talk about. Because if you say in 4 years of college life, you have only attended lectures, you don't have anything to talk about in the interview, right?
Yes.
So participate in a lot of things so that you can talk about it.
Okay. So any final words to the juniors that will be applying for the company?
Okay. So when you apply for Cognizant, you should know that the Cognizant management is not very strict. So I actually did an internship in Cognizant as my final semester. So I already have one foot into the company. So I have a general idea of how they work. So if you are going into Cognizant, please be focused about what you want to form your career path as, because they give you a lot of freedom. They will let you, they will give you projects to work on, but you have access to a lot of learning things and a lot of learning paths. So if you get the opportunity, decide which specific field you want to grow in and use all the opportunities that Cognizant gives you to grow in that sector. So I think that if you're joining Cognizant, you should know what you want to do or how you can use Cognizant and the resources that Cognizant has to offer.
Thanks a lot, Sophie. That was our time with Sophie. So you heard her that you have to be always active throughout the course, like in your college journey. So I hope everyone is satisfied with this thing. So peace out. Bye-bye.